Hello everyone, this is Dr. Sneha Shetty, Clinical Director, Chief Fertility Specialist, Gynecologist and Laparoscopic Surgeon here from Vriksh Fertility, HSR Layout, Bengaluru. Dysmenorrhea or pain during periods. This is a very common condition which I think as women we all have experienced pain during our periods. But for some women, it is a very, very extreme and it can hamper their day-to-day activities as well. So what are the causes of this dysmenorrhea? Dysmenorrhea can be classified into primary dysmenorrhea and secondary dysmenorrhea. Primary dysmenorrhea means there is no major medical condition. It is mainly due to the release of prostaglandins which are produced during our normal period cycle. Secondary dysmenorrhea means there is dysmenorrhea because of certain underlying medical condition like endometriosis, adenomyosis, uterine fibroids or cervical stenosis or other conditions like pelvic inflammatory disease, etc. What are the main features of this dysmenorrhea? Number one, there can be severe abdominal pain, lower abdominal pain, lower back pain, nausea, vomiting and associated symptoms like headache, easy fatigability and diarrhea sometimes. The intensity and duration of these symptoms can vary from person to person, from period cycle to cycle, and can also vary in between the periods or just prior to the periods, or more so gets exacerbated during the periods. So how do we diagnose this particular condition of dysmenorrhea? One is by taking detailed medical history. Second is by physical examination. Third is by doing certain diagnostic tests. So once all these three steps are done, your doctor will be able to come to a diagnosis of what the problem is and why are you having this severe dysmenorrhea and can give you treatment accordingly. So the treatment of dysmenorrhea is categorized into four main parts. The first is your symptomatic treatment. Depending on your symptom, your doctor will give you the medication. If it is for pain, your pain relief medication may be advised. If it is diarrhea or some other symptoms, accordingly your doctor will give you the treatment. Second is hormonal treatment. So hormonal treatment is usually the second line treatment which we usually give depending on how severe the condition is in order to regulate your hormones and manage your period cycle, which can be in the form of contraceptive pills, hormonal tablets or hormonal patches or hormonal injections depending on the condition. This helps in regulate the cycle and decreasing the pain associated. Third is surgical. If there is any associated condition like uterine fibroid or adenomyosis, severe endometriosis, surgery is planned accordingly to treat that particular underlying cause. Fourth, complementary therapies. Holistic approach to a dysmenorrhea treatment is very much important. These include certain relaxation techniques, acupuncture sessions, and also certain supplemental medication depending on your deficiencies like vitamin deficiencies or correcting the underlying other causes as well. Dysmenorrhea can significantly affect the day-to-day lifestyle. But discussing with your healthcare provider, your doctor, is very important as these symptoms can be managed and the resulting solutions are available. So there is a need for a lot of awareness to be created in the society and to break the stigma that period pain is normal.